Hello and welcome to this tutorial video on how to make a jointed teddy bear. Let's take a look at the contents of your kit box first. Inside you'll find your stuffing. This is polyfiber and there's enough to fill your bear completely, but we'll also look at other filling options later. Your fabric, this is Helmbolt German mohair we've got in this kit. You'll have your 5 quarter pin joints. There are hardboard discs, pins and washers. Your pattern and instructions, and then in the back of this pack you'll have your nose thread, extra strong thread for the eyes, a pair of handmade glass eyes, your long doll needle for inserting the eyes, paw pad fabric, and there's a checklist here. Just like putting together an IKEA wardrobe, it's worth reading the instructions first. This section here says that if this is the first jointed bear you've ever made, it is vital, and it really is vital, that you read these instructions first. It also encourages you, if you've not made a bear before, to take a look at the glossary. There'll be terms there that you might not be familiar with, and there's also a nice little guide to stitches, but you can also find these on our YouTube tutorials, and I will add links as we go along. Right, first of all, we're going to cut out our pattern. Inside your instruction booklet, you'll find your pattern sheets. Depending on what size bear you're making, you might have 1, 2, or even 3 pattern sheets. This is a 2-sheet pattern. And I'm going to cut this out and glue it onto card. I'm going to start with a head piece. So the first thing to do with this is using a pair of paper scissors, and please don't use your fabric scissors, it really does ruin the blades using them on paper. Cut around, not on the line, but around the outside of the pattern piece, leaving a gap, leaving a space around the entire pattern. And the reason we do this is that once it's glued onto card, we only have to cut on the black outline once, which means it's very accurate. Once you've done that, take a piece of card. Now, I only have white card to hand, but if you have something like a brown card, that's even better. And using a glue stick, which isn't wet enough to buckle your pattern piece, so these really are good, make sure you go right to the edges and liberally cover it. And then we're going to place it onto your card. And as I say, a coloured or even a brown card is great, something from a cereal packet or something like that, because on your layout it will show you that once your pattern piece is reversed, it's shown in a shaded colour, so it makes it much easier to tell which are the pieces that are the correct way around and which are reversed. Now I'm going to let that dry after I've pressed it down. Make sure there are no bubbles. And using the magic of camera, it's dry already. Now we can cut on that black outline. If you cut it out on the black line first, then glue it down and then cut around it again, there's a temptation to trim away at the black line. Take that piece away to make it easier to cut on the line. And because our seam allowance isn't huge, we want to get this right on the line. Go all the way around. Take your time. And then up over the top of the head here. And we'll come back in a little while to this line that's at the top of the head. Once you've gone all the way around. And you'll repeat this with each of your pattern pieces. It's worth taking the time to glue them onto card. It makes them much easier to reuse. There we go. Okay, let's get rid of these little bits. Now, as you can see, there's a dotted line here that we're going to cut into, and we're going to use this line for inserting the ears into the side of the head. That means we know that the positioning will be accurate. There are other ways of positioning ears by pinning and ladder stitching, and we'll look at those in another tutorial at another time. We've cut out all of our pattern pieces and glued them onto card. We have the head with a slit inside into which we'll insert the ears. We have the head gusset, one of those. We have the leg, the inner and outer arms, the paw pads, the ear and the body. On the body you'll see these darts which we'll use for shaping the body by sewing them together. And on the legs and inner arms you'll see these dots which we're going to make into holes because we want to be able to mark through those with pen. You'll see the par direction arrow, and let me talk you through that. Try brushing your hand in different directions across your fabric. Just like stroking a dog, if there's a par direction there'll be a comfortable way for the fabric to sit, and that direction from the base to the tip of the hair will match the arrow on your pattern piece. Now, using the layout in your instruction booklet, we're going to start laying the pattern pieces out. This is the body. We're going to fit it as close as we can to the edge, but I've deliberately left on the salvage here, which is the part of the mohair that's attached to the loom, and it doesn't have any pile on it, so you want to make sure that you're within the area of your mohair that has pile. And I'm using a biro. You can use a complicated and expensive fabric pen if you want, but to be honest, as long as it doesn't bleed and mark your fabric through, it doesn't really matter what you use, a pencil, a chalk pencil if you're using a dark fabric. I just find a biro is as good as anything for mohair. We're going to go all the way around. We're going to make sure we mark these points that are the markers for the cotter pins to go through, and we're also going to mark the opening at the back that we'll leave open for stuffing the bear. So mark this on the outside and then make sure you mark it onto the pattern so when you cut it out it's still evident. So there are our cotter pin markers, our darts all the way around, and our openings at the back. Let's have a look what next. We're going to go for a leg. Again, it's white on our layout, so that means it's the right side. There's absolutely no point leaving any gaps in between your pattern pieces. It's just wasted fabric, and mohair is expensive and we don't like waste. So you touch the pattern pieces together. You might as well just be careful of that edge. There may be no salvage on your fabric, but check first. Nothing more disappointing than cutting out your pattern pieces and finding out that you've got a bald patch. Right the way up the back, all the way around, and again mark the openings for the stuffing and the cotter pin point there. Just go over it if it's not clear. Make sure it's come onto your fabric, because when you cut it out you don't want to cut out those outer markers. Next, let's do the head. Of course, with each of these we're checking that the par direction is going in the right direction. We're going to draw all the way around again with our trusty biro, all the way up to the top and over. And on this piece we're going to lift down the side of the pattern and make sure we go right from the very, very bottom of that slit up to the top. We have to make sure we mark the full length so the ear is in the correct position. And there it is. Just as there. And we're going to finish laying out all of our pattern pieces until it looks like this. They're all laid out, they're fitted nicely. Take the time to check that you've got everything. Make sure you've marked things like the point at the end of the head gusset where it will meet the seam of the front of the head. You've got your cotter pin points marked, You've got your back markers for the stuffing. Check you've got all the right pieces. Now I've put the markers here for all of the leg pieces, but you'll only need them on two, because two pieces will be the outer parts of the leg, but it doesn't hurt. They're all there, just count them all, make sure they're all in place. Everything's marked on, that you've got your ear insert points. You're ready to go. Now, this is the fun bit. It's also the bit that makes people anxious. We're going to cut out using our little fabric scissors. And I find little scissors much easier, because it's not tempting to make big cuts, and you want little snips in your fabric with this. The way to do it is, again, indicating the fabric backing and the pile. You're going to go in between the strands of hair. And the way to do that is to place the bottom blade, slide it in between the hairs, and lay it flush against the fabric backing, and make little tiny snips. I'll show you on a piece of paper without cutting it, obviously. Lay your bottom blade against the back of the fabric and just move the top piece if you can. So, slide the blade in between the hairs, flush against the fabric backing, and with little tiny snips, moving the top blade, if you can just move the top blade, or just with little tiny snips so you're not catching the hairs, go all the way around, and you'll see as it pulls apart, you haven't cut any of these long hairs. And we're going to go all the way around like that, snipping away with our little tiny snips in between the hairs of the pile. Take your time. It's another point where it's not worth rushing. Mohair is expensive. You don't want to get it wrong. It really is a kind of check twice, cut once kind of thing. And when you cut down here exactly the same in between the pile, make sure you go right down to the bottom. These two slits being exactly the same on your two head side pieces is what's going to make your ears level on your finished bear. And we go all the way around until we end up with this. Now, if I turn it over, you can see the pile showing all the way around where we haven't cut through it. That's perfect. That's just the way you want it to be. And the same on the side where the slit is. There's no bits cut away. And that's done. We carry on with the rest of our pieces. Cutting the paw pads out is easier. You have a separate paw pad layout here. And because there's no paw direction, it's much easier. There's no arrow normally on paw pads. You may find it on some because you might want to use a pattern fabric. Lay them again right up to the edges. Even on cheaper fabrics, I really don't like waste. And I'm using, because this is a dark fabric, I'm using a white pencil this time to go all the way around the outside. Having these glued onto card makes it much easier. The paper doesn't bend if it's glued onto card. It's much easier to keep it straight. Now, this is the foot pad. That was the paw pad. This is the foot pad. And on the foot pad, once you've drawn around it, you'll notice that we have two little markers. One that indicates the heel and joins to the back seam, and one that indicates the toes and joins to the front seam. So make sure again these are on your pattern piece. And that all helps to line it up when you're putting it together. Now we have all of our pattern pieces cut out, four leg pieces with cotter pin markers on them. two body pieces with darts cut and with cotter pin markers and back opening. A head gusset, one head gusset with a marker at the front there that will match the seam. And for each arm, an outer and an inner. Because this has paw pads, the inner arms are different to the outer arms, and this paw pad will fit onto the inner arm to make it match. Four ear pieces, two head pieces with the head slits cut, and our foot pads. That's everything cut out. We're ready to go. In our next video, we'll sew our bear together.
That concludes our tutorial video. I hope it's been helpful. If it has, please subscribe to the channel, give us some feedback and a like. There are more videos coming soon.